So our next topic is tragacanth. Okay, so synonyms of tragacanth are gum tragacanth, tragacantha. Okay, the synonyms of tragacanth are gum tragacanth, tragacantha. Coming to biological source, so these are obtained from dried gummy exudations. Okay, exudations means excretion types. Okay, which ooze out of the plant. So these are dried gummy exudations obtained by incisions. Okay, obtained by incisions from stems and branches of what is the plant name? Astragalus gummifer. Okay, Astragalus gummifer is the plant name. Astragalus gummifer. Okay, belonging to the family Leguminosae. Belonging to the family Leguminosae. So coming to synonyms again, the synonyms of tragacanth are gum tragacanth, tragacantha. Biological source, these are dried gummy exudations which are obtained by incisions. Okay, obtained by incisions made from stems and branches of the plant Astragalus gummifer, belonging to the family Leguminosae. Okay, next one, geographical source, where they are been present. So these are generally found in India, Greece, Iraq, Syria. Okay, in India, these are found in Garhwal, Kumaon and Punjab. Garhwal, Kumaon and Punjab. These are the three areas in India where the trees are been cultivated or found. Okay, in general, they are found in India, Greece, Iraq and Syria. Next is cultivation and collection. Okay, so next one is cultivation and collection. So generally, these plants are grown at an altitude of 1000 to 3000 meters. So generally, these plants are grown at an altitude of 1000 to 3000 meters. They are very thorny in nature. Okay, they have spikes, okay, spines of things. Okay, so generally, these plants grow at an altitude of 1000 to 3000. They are thorny in nature. Next, incisions, so cuts. Okay, incisions means cuts. So incisions are made on the bark of the plant. So this is the plant. So here they will do cuts on the plants. Then what will happen? The gummy substances comes out of the plant. Okay, gums oozes out immediately, which is left for drying. Okay, which is left for drying and later on collected. The cells of the pith and medullary rays transform into gummy substances. So these plants contain two things, that is cells of pith and medullary rays. These two in combined form convert into gummy substances. Okay, inside plant, the cells of the pith and medullary rays, they transform into gummy substances. Next one, these are found in the form of flattened flakes. What is their structure look like? They look like flattened flakes, okay, with ribbon like appearance. After oozing out of the plant, they are like this type of structures. Okay, so that's why these are flattened flake like ribbon like appearance. Okay, next, mostly collected from April to November. Mostly collected from April to November. Next, coming to description. So as we said, in acacia, the gums are known as tears. Okay, in acacia, the gums are known as tears, whereas here the gums are known as flakes. Okay, here they are known as flakes. So coming to description, the flakes are white or yellowish white in color. The flakes are white or yellowish white in color. Order, orderless. Taste, mucilaginous. Shape, ribbon like. Okay, coming to size, there are in acacia, what we read, size and shape means the various shapes and size. Okay, whereas here the flakes are 25 into 12 into 2 mm in size. The flakes are 25 into 12 into 2 mm in size. Okay, so this is about starting introduction points, that is tragacanth. Synonyms are tragacanth, gum tragacanth and tragacantha. Okay, next, biological source, these are dried gummy exudations which are obtained by incisions from stems and branches of the plant Astragalus gummifer, belonging to the family Leguminosae. Okay, geographical source, India, Greece, Iraq, Syria. In India, Garhwal, Kumaon, Punjab. Okay, cultivation and collection, cultivation and collection. Generally, these plants grow at an altitude of 1000 to 3000 meters. They are thorny. Incisions are made on the barks so that gum oozes out immediately, which is left for drying. Okay, they are kept aside for drying and later on collected. Here, how gum is obtained means the cells of pith and medullary rays transform into gummy substance. Next, these are found in the form of flattened flakes. How these are found? These are found in the form of flattened flakes with ribbon-like appearance. Mostly collected from April to November. Okay. Description: the flakes are white or yellowish white in color. So what is the color? Color is white or yellowish white in color. Order is orderless. Taste is mucilaginous. Shape is ribbon-like. And size is 25 into 12 into 2 mm size. Okay. Next, coming to chemical constituents. So, coming to chemical constituents, tragacanth has two portions: water soluble portion and water insoluble portion. Okay, water soluble portion and water insoluble portion. Water soluble portion is known as tragacanthin, which is about 8 to 10% of the whole drug. Okay, tragacanthin, which is about 8 to 10% of the whole drug, and water insoluble portion is known as bassorin, which constitutes about 60 to 70% of the whole drug. Okay, if you take a drug of 100%, in that 8 to 10% tragacanthin is present and 60 to 70% bassorin is present. Okay, next, and also contains 15% methoxy group, which swells in water. Okay, and also contains 15% of methoxy group, which swells in water. So this drug swells in water because it has methoxy group in it. Okay. Next, tragacanth on hydrolysis produces. So this drug, when it comes to hydrolysis, it produces galacturonic acid, D-galactopyranose, L-arabinoramnose, okay, and D-xylopyranose. Okay, tragacanth on hydrolysis, what does it produce? It produces galacturonic acid, okay, D-galactopyranose, L-arabinoramnose, and D-xylopyranose. These are the four things. These are the four elements which are obtained after tragacanth is undergone for hydrolysis. Okay, next. Finally, chemical tests. So, sample is taken and it is added with aqueous ferric chloride solution. You will get deep yellow precipitate. Okay. Sample, when we take the sample and we add ferric chloride solution, it produces deep yellow precipitate. Whereas sample with sodium hydroxide solution produces canary yellow color. Canary is a bird name. Okay, bird name. It has a distinct or a unique yellow color. So that's why its name has obtained as canary yellow color. Next, sample plus strong iodine solution. Sample plus strong iodine solution produces green color. So these are the three chemical tests which we need to read. That is, sample plus ferric chloride solution, aqueous ferric chloride solution produces deep yellow color. Sample plus sodium hydroxide solution produces canary yellow color. Sample plus strong iodine solution produces green color. Okay. Next, uses. It is used as a demulcent, emollient in cosmetics. Next, emulsifying agent, suspending agent, binding agent in preparation of tablets, used in lotions, and also as a stabilizer in ice creams, and also used as a stabilizer in ice creams. So if they ask what are the medicinal uses of tragacanth, you need to write all those things. Okay, this is about tragacanth.